Hey, my beauties! It's Miss Unique Beauty in the building, and I'm back with another video. If you guys are new to my channel, tap that subscribe button so that you won't miss out on any of my new uploads. And if you have already subscribed, what's good? What's poppin'? Welcome back to my channel. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Miss Unique Beauty. The wig in today's video was sent to me by a company called Neat and Sleek, and they were kind enough to send me their 13x6 knotless box braids lace front wig. And I did get it in this gorgeous triple tone color, which is an ombre from black to brown to platinum 613. Now this wig does come with adjustable straps, 3 combs, and an elastic band. The first thing that I'm going to go ahead and do is apply my Got To Be Glued Ultra Glued Styling Gel to my edges, and I'm going to use this to slick my edges going all the way back. And once I got that all onto my edges, I am going to go in with my brush, and I'm going to brush my edges going back, making sure everything in the front is nice and flat. And then I am going to go in with my blow dryer to dry this nice and dry, just so that none of my hair will be in the way during this installation process. Now that my edges are nice and dry, I'm gonna go ahead and apply my wig cap to my head. Now, once I get that wig cap on, I want this wig cap to lay as flat as possible along my head. So I am gonna go ahead and cut holes by the ears just so I can get the cap to lay nice and flat around my ear tabs. I do feel like this process is very crucial to having your wig look nice and flawless on your head. The next thing I'm going to do is use my Got To Be Glued High Insta-Hold Hairspray, and I'm going to spray this along the entire front section of the cap. And I am being very generous with this spray because I want this cap to lay down nice and secure. Now, after I'm done spraying the entire front section of the cap, I am gonna go in with my blow dryer and blow dry this front section until it's completely dry. You wanna make sure that it is dry and it's not wet at all, because you do not want the cap to lift or move once you go ahead and cut away the excess cap. Now that the cap is all dry, I am going to go ahead and cut away the excess material that's on the front of the cap. And you guys want to make sure that you're not cutting your edges and that you're not cutting yourself as well. So be very careful with this process and take your time. Do not rush. Now I am going to go ahead and cut off one side on camera, and I'm going to go ahead and cut the next side off of camera because it was just a lot easier for me to see a lot better in the mirror. Now this is what the cap is looking like after I went ahead and cut away the excess. Now I'm going to go in with a little bit of the Got To Be Ultra Glued just to tack down the cap in the front that still looks a little bit lifted up. So I'm only going to apply a very little to the front section, then I'm going to go in with my blow dryer to dry that completely dry, and then it's time for the installation process. Now I'm going to go in with my Juvia's Place foundation, and I'm going to use this to tint the cap, and I'm also going to use this to tint the underside of the lace on the wig. Now, you guys do not have to use this specific foundation. You can use whatever foundation you like. Just make sure that it is your foundation skin color. this is what the lace on the wig is looking like. As you guys can see, it matches my skin perfectly. Now I'm gonna go ahead and apply the wig to my head. And as you guys can see, this wig is definitely giving me scalpiana. I am absolutely in love with how the front section of this wig was constructed. The scalp on this wig looks absolutely amazing. Now I'm gonna go in and spray the Gatsby Glued High Insta Hold Hairspray on the front section of the cap just to get this wig all nicely secured in the front. And then I'm gonna go in with my blow dryer and dry that entire section completely dry. Now I'm gonna go ahead and cut away the excess lace on the front section of the wig. Now I do have an extremely low hairline, so this wig did not fit my hairline as well as I thought it would. So for future references, if you guys do have a low hairline just like I do, you may have to leave just a little bit of your edges out to blend it a lot better with the front section of this wig. But nevertheless, this wig is absolutely gorgeous. Now I'm gonna go ahead and begin with styling the baby hair. So I did go ahead and take that braid out. Now I'm gonna go ahead and trim up these baby hairs, make them a lot shorter than what they are. And then I'm gonna go in with my Nairobi foamy mousse to style my edges and to make them look the best way I can in the front section of this wig. While I finish up this process, I do want to talk to you guys a little more about this wig and why to choose braided wigs. Now, this wig is called Leah on their website, and I did choose the option to have them waist length and also the cap size medium. So you can choose different lengths of this specific wig and different cap sizes of the specific wig as well. Now, for me, I love braided wigs because if you are tired of sitting hours and hours and hours of getting your hair braided in the salon, this wig is perfect for you. If you hate your hair being super duper tight at the root, this wig is definitely for you. If you cannot braid your own hair, but you still want to have your hair braided at an affordable price on your own, this wig is perfect for you. If you are struggling with hair loss or having any type of thinning around your edges, this wig is perfect for you. These are four reasons of why you guys need to go and pick up this gorgeous lace front braided wig. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the link to this wig and their website in the description box below so that you guys can go ahead and check them out. Now that I've completed my edges, I am gonna go ahead and tie them up with my silk scarf. And I'm gonna leave this scarf on for about 10 minutes or until my edges are completely dry. This is what my edges are looking like, and this is what the wig is looking like completely melted onto my head. Now, as you guys can see, this wig is looking absolutely flawless. I love the triple tone in this wig, and I absolutely love how super duper natural the scalp is looking as well. Now I'm gonna go ahead and dip the ends of this wig in scorching hot water. You guys wanna be careful with this process. And what it does, it helps to seal the ends on the ends of the braids. And this is what my hair is looking like. Now we're gonna go ahead and get into my slow-mo. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. comment down below any suggestions or questions that you guys may have. Smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe. Bye, my beauties!